This program is rated PG. It contains themes and scenes which may not be suitable for very young audiences. Parental guidance is advised.
Be advised that the views and opinions of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
The Philippines, our law, our politics, and media. I'm left with a degree of desperation and consternation. Ano? Itong ating halo-halo na image at hindi tayo makapaproject ng isang malinaw na imahe ng ating bansa. Despite, of course, some progress in the area of drug elimination of the problem, and of course dito sa foreign policy tuwa ako, pero it seems 90% of the problem is our image, no? And when will our politicians and particularly our media get together to sort out this mess? Anyway, our guest is Attorney Trixie Angeles, and I've known her for at least half a decade, maybe 2 decades now. One decade at least. And I was surprised to find out that she is a publisher of Politico.com. Of course, I follow her discussions on Facebook, basically. Yes. Ano? And tuwan-tuwa ako dahil laking tulong sa akin na walang oras na pag-aralan yung mga pangyayari from a legal point of view at yung kanyang Politico.com. Yung mga discussions niya ay malaking tulong po sa mga ordinaryong mamamayan tulad natin, ano. And so we asked her to join us to help us explain what's going on in the Senate hearings, but over and above that, anong nangyayari sa bayan natin, no? So si Attorney Trixie Angeles sa handle the cases of Oakwood, yung kaila Marine Colonel at that time, Kerubin, in 2006. So she has been in the limelight for the past decade and a half at least, ano? And so, tanungin natin kay Attorney Trixie, yung Politico.com, hindi ko alam na sa iyo pala yon. I see it, no?
Yeah.
And you're the publisher there. What was the inspiration for this?
Mostly because the national pastime appears to be politics. Mm-hmm. Politics and politicians. Uh-huh. So we wanted to do something that catered specifically to that interest. As we noticed, you know, it gets shared a lot on Facebook. Mm. A lot of our hits come from mm-hmm. that. It's because the current issues of the day demand discussion, and people, there's an insatiable search for more information regarding politics and politicians.
Yung mga nagtatayo ng mga diaryo, may intention yun na kumita. Ano?
Yes.
Yung mga nagtatayo ng mga websites na ganito, I don't think this is ever the first thought, di ba?
No.
So sa iyo, advocacy?
Yes, primarily.
Ano yung advocacy niyan? Truth, justice, and the Filipino way, if this is a Filipino way?
Actually, it wasn't really. It was something that we were doing for no reason.
Uh-huh.
It's one of those things that social media was a new thing. Let's see what we can do with this. And mm-hmm. I've been doing a lot of microblogging, which is Facebook.
Okay.
And a lot of my posts have gone viral.
Anong pangalan ng blog mo? Trixie Angeles?
Yeah, it's Facebook. It's just my page. Facebook is microblogging, actually. You don't have an actual website.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but a lot of my status messages or notes went viral. So we're kicking around the idea.
A lot of bloggers, aside from sino ba yung naging popular sa ano, yung sa yung entertainer, yung comedian, Marnie ba yun?
Lourdes de Vera?
There's a, yung may tandem sila. A lot of bloggers become sensational, become mainstream, no?
Yes.
And of course, the other a blogger, si Katrina Stewart
Santiago yes.
became a columnist of Manila yes. Times from her blog. Ano?
Yes.
And in your case, anong transition mo? You were a lawyer, and then 2 years ago you started the blog. Before before the Politico.com, you were just on Facebook giving your commentaries, and that became very popular. Is that the
actually
trend?
It started when my client at the time was Nick Feldon. He's okay. now the commissioner in customs.
Okay.
He had a website, and when he escaped
the
first
year
time,
2007.
He escaped in 2006.
Yeah. Okay.
And then again in 2007.
Yeah.
So, but
2007. When was the Manila Pen?
December 2007.
Ayon. Okay. Yeah. Now, yeah. Now I recall.
So, yeah.
I was there also.
Yeah, you were. I remember. I was at the hearing.
Yeah.
So when he escaped, his website got 2 million hits.
Yes.
And he asked me to
website. Really?
Okay. It was his website. And he asked me to write a few articles.
Okay.
So then he noticed that every time I put in an article, it would get, at the time, 200 hits was a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So he said that, you know, people are reading you. But he said that, why don't you put up a Facebook page so that more people will read? So. And then it became just easier to post on Facebook, and then they would just grab it and put it on his website. So later on, when he came back and the website was gone, I just continued on Facebook. And then it started in the early years of the Aquino administration. In fact, if you remember the Luneta hostage taking.
Yes.
I wrote a note that went viral. It went madly viral at the time when 100 shares was already a lot. It got something like 2,500 shares. And it was being reposted and columnists were talking about it. And somebody asked me, well, why don't you do a blog? And I said, I don't have the patience.
But this Politico.com, you have formal reporters, you have formal regular writers. Organisado na ba yan?
When you say formal reporters, like their employees, most of the people who write for Politico are volunteers.
Volunteers,
yeah, like
okay.
me. So, which is why I don't write so often.
Okay.
But when I do, it's the publisher's note.
But people recognize some regularity in
yes,
the people
yes,
who write or the contributors to the
It's more like
site.
A commitment. We started it, and it kind of snowballed. We didn't, a lot of us just get high on the hits.
That's
how it started.
Would you say that these sites would be more earnest and reliable in terms of honesty? Kasi walang masyadong parameters na commercial and so on.
We've actually been offered several times to buy us out, but we're still having too much fun with it.
Okay.
So mostly it's because we're having fun. A lot of the writers are very young.
Many of them are still supported by their parents. Ganyan siguro.
Most likely.
Tulad ng kaming mga bata, kaming aktivista.
Yes.
Eh, talagang walang
limits
kasi
uuwi
kami, pakakainin kami.
Correct.
Pati yung mga kapwa aktivista, dadalhin sa bahay, yung refrigerator, bubuksan, uubusin, tapos lalabas na lang, mag-rally na naman.
Yes.
So yung talagang kusang-kusa.
Yes, actually bisyo nga.
That's exciting. And the fact that I got this desire to invite you to this show discussion, part of the motive is hoping that your many hits drawn to this show.
It
no?
definitely will, at least when you post this on YouTube. Some people live on the internet. So.
But of course, the essential matter here is that you have been doing great analysis of the, for example, the Senate hearings. You know, you have been very fair. You know. On Duterte and the critics of Duterte, I think your commentaries have been very fair and very balanced. And the one of the immediate provocations for me to invite you,
yeah.
I was provoked because of the discussion on the last episode episodes of the Senate hearings.
Oh, yeah,
walkout
yeah.
ni De Lima, testimony ni Mato Bato ba yun, ang tawag na?
Before that.
Mato Bato.
The police officer.
Initially,
yeah.
maraming naghihintay at parang napapaniwala dahil, but later on, there's a lot of discredit to that testimony with the subsequent testimony of those other policemen and so on. No?
Yes.
So that was very interesting. And of course, a highlight in the past week was yung walkout ni De Lima, which you were just narrating. I did not watch it because, as I told you, wala namang oras na manood ng ganyan. Mabuti kayo, nakakapanood kayo at nakaka-analyze kayo nito.
Yeah, I live on Facebook.
Ganyan. How many hours a day on Facebook?
I don't know. When I'm doing other work, like I still write now, and I still do a lot of consultancy work. So it's always on. So when something is going
on. Kalaki bang screen mo? Baka o laptop lang.
I use a laptop, but I have several TVs going on. Because we do media monitoring.
I should go and shoot your room or ano para maintindihan ng tao how this works pala. How many TV monitors do you have?
6.
Wow.
But yeah, it's partly because the politico relies also on commentary.
That's right,
so
that's
we do a lot of commentary, we do a lot of repackaging of the news. So it's a necessity.
Well, you're dedicated to this local scene. Ako naman, umaga, gabi, madaling araw, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, I review the international websites on Syria, Russia, China, US.
Yeah, I really have to ask you about
potential
that.
Na gera, yung mga ganyan. Okay. Now, let's go focus on the issue of the drug campaign of President Duterte. Ang reaction ko, natutuwa ko because despite my youngest, I have twins, no? Na kritiko sila ni Duterte. Parang maraming mga bata kritiko ni Duterte, no? Of a certain social class, di ba?
Yes, possibly.
Sinasabi ko kasi Lasal kayo, Ateneo kayo, USD kayo, mayabang kayo, kaya tingin niyo doon sa Dutertards na tawag nila na and so on so forth, no? Pero ako nakikita ko na just by the fact that 600,000-700,000 volunteered to come out.
Yes.
Malaking bagay na yun. And I'm convinced na disrupt yung flow of supply, tumataas na daw ang presyo ng shabu
yes,
and therefore that means the supply is getting tight, and so there is progress. And there is an exaggeration of the EJK, which is not an issue, di ba? EJK, is it an issue talaga?
No, it's an issue of perceptions. In fact, most netizens, we call them, people on social media, understand that this is an actual crisis, at least not for President Duterte, given his approval rating. It's really a crisis of perceptions, which is why you still have people holding over from elections. During the elections, and this is standard in any elections, you have what we call keyboard warriors.
Keyboard warriors,
yes.
Okay.
So you have the committed ones, the ones who are doing this because they truly believe it. These are the activists. And then they're the ones where you can actually hire.
Yung troll na yan.
Trolls, yes.
That's why I was disputing
troll
this
factories.
This generalization of trolls. Sinasabi ko, may mga troll at may mga earnest critics.
Yes,
you really cannot differentiate siguro at some point.
No, at some point, no. But there are some who you can tell, you can spot the trend.
Well, unang-una, kung totoong pangalang ginagamit.
That's one.
Di ba?
The other is when they're incapable, you engage them into a full discussion.
And magdidebate sila.
If
tututok
they cannot,
sila.
If they cannot debate, it means a shallow perception
troll,
of the
troll
issue.
Na yon, yes. More or less troll na yon.
Yes, they'll repeat certain keywords or certain yun. Concepts.
Ulit-ulit nilang ilang mga phrases.
We saw this a lot during elections. So, it's a business. But that's okay. But right now, because it's played out on an international stage, the perception is that somebody is pushing this machinery. Given the approval rating,
somebody or somebodies, kasi mukhang maraming gumagawa.
Yeah, but it's a virtual explosion of negative publicity for the president, and it doesn't tally with the numbers of people who support him. So it seems that the noise is much louder than the actual number of people. So that's how it's being played. That's how it's really a battle of perceptions. And the thing is that there is a minority who's capable of attracting foreign media and making this really look like it's played out on the world stage.
Well, you mentioned
stage.
Media. That's why binanggit natin sa title natin yung media. Yung foreign media is not helping any.
No.
And I want to point out that the foreign media is really Western media. Kasi oh, yeah. tayo din, sasabihin nila, that international community.
Yes.
Galit kay Duterte dahil dito, dahil doon. Sino bang international? So, sinasabi ko sa, but it's a small voice. Kasi yung mga nagpapasok nitong international media daw, ang dami-dami nila. Yes. Pero sino bang international? China, 1.4 billion. India, 1.1 billion. Eh, halos kalahati na ng mundo. Hindi naman sila umaangal laban kay Duterte.
So,
and in fact, popular ang si Duterte sa Africa, sa Indonesia, yung mga galit sa Estados Unidos and the Western powers, di ba?
So, yeah. So, but it works in both ways, no? So, what was that they tell you? Just because it's written down doesn't mean it's true. Mm. So it's the same thing.
There are still some people who upon reading in the newspapers in only one newspaper, halimbawa yung mga Inquirer readers, merong hindi na nagbabasa ng ibang diaryo because they think that's gospel truth already.
So actually, you'll see a disturbing trend here. You have traditional media who have forays in social media, so they will have their websites, but they're not exactly geared towards social media. Mm. Social media is fast, it's immediate, and it's in your face. Mm. There are no idols here. Mm. Everybody is placed at the same level. Mm. So, you know,
pero doon naiinis din ako eh. Merong obviously hindi nagbabasa.
Ayan,
pero kung magdebate, parang marunong sila.
Well,
alam mo naman ikaw nagbabasa ka at ang dami, ang habang susulatin mo.
Yeah.
Tapos babastusin ka lang ang sagot. Isa, dalawang linya.
Yeah, so
Rinespetuhin ba natin yon?
Well, that's why you call them trolls.
Well, okay.
Their purpose really isn't to contribute to anything to the discussion. Mm. They're just there to make you angry. Mm. And they get off on it. Mm. That's the original meaning of a troll.
Mm.
All they're doing is trying to get push your buttons.
Mm.
And if they can do that in one or two lines, siga sila, di ba? Because they get off on it.
Pero madalas, sinasabi ko, yung iba sasabihin, huwag mo lang i-debate yan, walang
kwenta
yan. Pero ang sinasabi ko, kaya ako nagpapatuloy nito para yung ibang mga nagbabasa, nakikita.
Yes,
ano?
And they have an alternative source of information other than there's so much noise out there.
No.
So you get that. But here's the trend, in case you notice. There's a huge campaign against what they call false websites.
Si Atong Araulio came out with an expose of this, no?
Yes. But these are backed up by traditional media. Mm. So do you see where the lines are being drawn here?
Ah, okay.
So the thing about social media, the thing about the internet was to provide the alternative source of information.
Mm.
And it doesn't rely on the kind of evidentiary requirement that traditional media will require. They'll need sources. They'll need, even if their sources are confidential, they have to be real. Yeah, they have to be producible, even if you don't actually produce them.
Mm.
Whereas social media or the internet is free to speculate. Yes, and they can work on very few
and
facts.
It's up to the reader in social media to make judgments. Kasi yung traditional media, may mga ikokot silang authorities and sources. Pero sinet up din yan ng mga may vested interest.
In social media, who they say are the reliable sources, sila din.
Mm.
So they'll say, I will quote only reliable sources. Mm. Well, who are you quoting this time? They'll quote a major newspaper. So it feeds into that. So there's a lot of this going on. If you're smart, you will spot the trend.
Mm.
The trying to disqualify from the national conversation blogs. If the blogger prefers to be anonymous, which is your privilege in the internet, they will say that you're not credible. But why do you need to be known? Why do you have to have a name if your facts are right?
Yeah.
So in fact, that is why the internet is a great source of amusement and information. And it is the alternative.
Just last week, I think the source is WikiLeaks, but I'm not sure right now, but you can see it in the internet. May report that the Pentagon spent $540 million to create fake Syrian war scenarios, scenes, no? But we're running out of time, so we'll move on. One of my criticisms for all sides in the drugs discussion is for those with Duterte, they are not going beyond what is happening now.
Yes.
And for those critics of Duterte, they're not going beyond what they're saying now. And when I suggest that, why don't you try to bring up the issue of decriminalization? Because in Portugal, we have some statistics there. Portugal decriminalized around 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And drug use, marijuana, and even shabu went down to around 5% of what it previously was. Yes. You know? When I suggest to the anti-Duterte and anti-drug campaign people, why don't you bring up the issue of decriminalization? So you have a policy prescription.
Yes.
Ah, mahirap yan. Hindi papayag ang Catholic Church dyan, and so on. So, you know, where are we going to get some forward momentum if we stop ourselves from discussing other policies to resolve the crisis? Anyway, Trixie, what do you think?
I think that they don't live in a bubble. I mean, nobody does. Already the talk about decriminalization has begun. We have a DSWD secretary gearing up for massive drug rehabilitation program. So drug rehabilitation is precisely already part of that. It feeds into the legalization thing.
Yeah.
Because if you were very strict about it, even drug use can lead to imprisonment. You do get an out. Instead of being convicted, you can opt for drug rehab. And then that's, you know, two strikes, you're out. Mm-hmm. But it's the elephant in the room, I think, the decriminalization. But I think that because you can't do one without the other, they have to make tokhang work first.
You cannot have decriminalization without the repression.
Yes, actually.
Okay, yeah.
You have to establish first the, how do you call this? You have to establish the social mores.
Yeah.
You have to establish make it strong of a foothold in society, so that when it is decriminalized, they don't have people going overboard.
But I was surprised. Of course, we share this source, Sasso Gandoba, Sasot, and she was for decriminalization, but not for shabu.
Yes.
But if you don't go all out for decriminalization, you'll end up with the same thing. Some people hiding, becoming victims, and not getting assistance, and so on. But we won't end on this topic. You know?
Yes.
We'll go back to our broader issue of Philippine society, law, politics, and media. But your reaction to my last point about decriminalization. Shouldn't it be all out? When people ask me, I say, dapat yung shabu nabibili sa mga drugstores natin.
Ano?
Pero
may
reseta, may address para pwede ka rin, bibigyan ka rin ng tarjeta ng doktor whom you can visit, maybe a social worker. Mm-hmm. Ano? Kasi, sinong gumagamit ng shabu? From what I, ito, concrete, isang pamangkin ng kaibigan ko, sabi, 100 piso lang ng shabu, 3 araw, hindi na siya kailangan kumain, hindi siya na nagugutom. Totoo ito. This is real. This is a real case, kaya ako, kumbinsido ako eh.
Well, it isn't.
Walang pambili kasi ng pagkain eh.
Well, plus, you're awake. So, there are certain laborers who take it.
Yung mga drivers.
Drivers, people who have to work long hours, people have to stay awake. So, it's not a surprise that even professionals have been taking
advertising
that.
People, yung mga kailangan may deadline na tatapusin. Yes, but we have only 60 seconds left. How do we put this together and create a saner, more rational society?
I think the answer to anything, any of the social problems, is always more information.
Mm.
You need to have an informed public, which is why it's important to have your social media. It's important to challenge your traditional media. The one thing that we're taught in UP law is that nothing is ever cast in stone. You have a law, you can unmake that law.
That's right.
You have jurisprudence, you can challenge that jurisprudence. And that's what modern thinking is all about. You have to evolve, which is what I think goes into the crux of the issue right now. The deep divisions aren't between yellows and tards.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's really between people who are confused about the rapid changes that are going on around them. This is not the world they grew up in. This is not the world where you could identify who were the good people. Mm. We had been sold the story of good versus evil. Yellow equals good, therefore everything else is evil. And now that story is turned on its ear. Suddenly you have a good guy, who walks and talks like a villain. And it's simply unacceptable.
Si Duterte yun. Parang kontrabida magsalita, but he's really trying to do good.
Yes, it's the scruffy protagonist. We're not used to that. We're used to our protagonists well-dressed and speaking in English.
Oh, kaya nga. Ito ay simula lang ng discussion natin with Attorney Trixie Angeles. We'll have more in the future. But we've run out of time for this segment. Mabuhay po kayo natin. Salamat, Attorney Trixie.
Thank you.
And okay. Keep up the good work of Politico.com.
Thank you.
Yung mga nagbabasa ng Inquirer, bawas-bawasan nyo yan. Lumipat kayo sa Politico.com. Okay. So let's take this break.